Welcome back in my class. Today my topic is product of tourism as well as the seller of tourism. My main discussion is going on the sellers of tourism, means the travel agency. But before starting my discussion, I have to discuss a little bit about the tourism product. In business, there are two types of business you can find here, like a product business and a service business. Service is in the nature, it is the inseparable, intangible characteristics, inseparable, variable, and absence of ownership, means intangible, which we can't see, we can touch, but we buy, like that. We can explain like that the product. If you going to buy a fridge, you can see this fridge on spot, but if you going to buy a tour of Taj Mahal, you can't see the Taj Mahal on spot. So that you buy the things, but you can see and you can touch on spot. And why it is variable? Because here a persons may like the monuments and some persons may like the shopping. So that if you arrange a tour for the persons who may doesn't like much monuments, they may say the place is not that much good. But if any history lovers or monuments lovers went there, they told that the product is so good. So it's vary to person to person and inseparable. You can't separate the product from the seller. If you go to buy a fridge, the seller may not behave you well, but fridge, it is doesn't matter how the fridge will work. Fridge will work in the same conditions. But if a seller of tourism behave very badly with you, then and there your product experience will be very bad. So it will be converted in a bad experience. So that you may say that, no, that place is not much good, I didn't feel much comfortable over there, my other place was good, like that. So what I have to say that now, you will not get the ownership when you buy the product. Suppose when you buy a fridge, you will get then and there the ownership of this fridge. But if you buy a tour of Taj Mahal, then you will not be the owner of Taj Mahal. You can't bring Taj Mahal in your home. It's an experience. So it's an intangible service product. Now we can divide it tourism product into the three types. One is the nature made, one is the man made, and one is the symbolic. What is nature made? It's a very common sense. We can find that desert, hill stations, river belts, beaches, all that comes under the nature-made tourism. And man-made tourism, the monuments, palaces, forts, amusing parks, etc. comes under it. But what is symbolic? It is the most important product in tourism. Symbolic means the collaborations of nature and man-made products. Means, suppose there is a beautiful beach in Chandrabhaga, but nearby a king made a Surya temple over there, means sun temple. Yeah, this is the Konark Rath temple or Chari temple. Konark Chari temple. This collaborations of the man-made product and nature-made products makes the attractions more high. So like that, amusing parks and all in a Goa, you can find the water sports over there in a beach. And in Kerala, you can find the Ayurvedic spa, all those things. This comes under the symbolic products. So now, who are the seller of these products? In tourism business, travel agencies are the main sellers of the tourism products. So there are so many types of travel agencies. The retailer travel agencies, wholesalers, and tour operators. So they all are selling the tourism product as a package to the directly customers or by selling by the middleman. Now I am going to discuss about the type of travel agencies and their functions. The functions of a modern travel agency has widened generally after the introduction of the jet air travels. The travel agency gave advice to the potential tourist on the merits of alternative destinations and to make necessary arrangement for a chosen holiday, which may involve the booking of accommodation, transport or other relevant services. Type of travel agencies. Retail travel agencies. A retail travel agency sells tourist products directly to the public on behalf of product suppliers and the in return gets the commission. Some package tours are sold in a two way, that is on a commission basis and markup price. Wholesaler travel agency. These agencies are especially in organizing package tours, which are marketed to the customer or tourist through the network of retail travel agencies or directly to the prospective clients. A wholesaler travel agency purchases tourist product components in bulk and designs packages too. Sometimes a wholesaler travel agency buy travel components from the vendors in bulk and resell them to another travel business organization. Tour operator. An organization, firm or company who buy individual travel components separately from their suppliers and combines them into a package tour, which is sold with their own price tag to the public directly or through the middleman, is called a tour operator. They can provide these services themselves, as some have their own cars and coaches, hotels and other travel related services, or can obtain these from the other suppliers. That is why they are called manufacturers of tourism product. Type of tour operator. Inbound tour operator. These are also known as incoming tour operators. Technically, the operators who receive guests or client or tourist and handle arrangement in the host country are called inbound tour operator. For example, a group of American tourists in coming through ICI Limited of India, and the company makes arrangement and handled the group in India, then ITC is called an inbound tour operator. Outbound tour operator. Tour operator who promote tour to foreign destinations, maybe business tour or leisure tour, and called of outbound tour operator. Indian outbound tourist traffic is growing at the rate of 10% annually, and this makes India the second largest country in the world with the regards to the traveling population. Domestic tour operator. Domestic tour operator are those who assemble combined tourist components into the inclusive tour and sell it to the domestic travelers. In generally, these tour operators provide travel services within the tourist's native or home country. Destination management companies or ground operator. These are the commonly known as handling agencies and their main functions is the organized tour arrangement for the incoming tourist on behalf of the overseas operators. When a tour operator himself promotes beach holidays, wildlife holidays, adventure tours, heritage tours, cultural tours, etc. at different places, the difficulties arises. It is the ground operators then who by handling the incoming travelers in the same season but at a different place, ensure that the either operating is the according to the package tour or arrangement. So next day probably I will going to discuss the functions of travel agency. For today, bye bye.